Hi guys, welcome to my channel Payal's Recipe. Today I'm going to show you a very delicious Shahi recipe that's made with Nutrella or meal maker or soya chunks that we may call. And it's easy to make and let's get started. The ingredients for this recipe are, I have this Nutrella or meal maker or soya chunks that I boiled in water with a little bit of salt, therefore it's soft. And this is the cashew nut paste. I have some oil, some whole spices, roughly chopped onions, roughly chopped green chilies, some ginger, garlic, roughly chopped tomatoes, cilantro. This is yogurt, that's about 1/4 cup. And these are the dry spices. This is the coriander powder or dhania powder, the roasted cumin powder, salt to taste, some red chili powder, but this is the degi mirch powder, and haldi or turmeric. The first thing that I want to do is heat the pan and add the oil. And once the oil is hot, I'm going to add some whole spices. And I have bay leaves, cinnamon, cloves, black pepper, some mace or javitri, and this is the dagar phool or the stone flower. Next, I'm going to add the onions. And the green chilies. And just saute them till they're slightly brown. Now I'm going to add the garlic and the ginger. And now mix everything. And let it saute for one more minute before we add the tomatoes. Now let's add the tomatoes. Just lower the flame and just saute the tomatoes till they are soft, and then we are going to grind the whole mixture. So I'm going to add the salt so the tomatoes soften faster, and just mix everything. I'm just going to cover it for a few minutes till the tomatoes become soft and then grind the whole mixture. Now let's check on our tomatoes. Yeah, and they've become really soft. And now let's grind this entire mixture with the tomatoes, onions, ginger, garlic, green chilies, and the whole spices. Now let's check on our masala. And it smells really good with all the spices. Let's continue with our cooking. And this is the masala that I just made. And in this same pan, I'm going to add this masala. I'm going to add some water and then remove the excess masala stuck to this. Now I've added a little water to this, and this is our delicious masala. And now to this masala, I'm going to add a few other things like the yogurt and the other dry spices like the degi mirch or the Kashmiri lal mirch powder, haldi, dhania powder, and the roasted jeera powder. Now after adding all these things, I'm going to just give it a mix. And now I'm going to add the Nutrella or the meal maker or soy chunks that are already boiled in a little bit of water with a little bit of salt. I'm also going to add the cilantro and then just give it a quick mix. And now to this, I'm going to add some water. And after adding some water, I'm going to mix it Just keep the gas on low flame and let it simmer on low flame for a few minutes. Now let's check on our gravy. It smells really good because of those whole spices. And now I'm going to add the cashew nut paste that I made. And this is the cashew nut paste that I made this morning, but I soaked it in water overnight before making a paste out of it. So I'm just going to add this and just mix it. So I'm just going to cover it and keep it on low flame for another 5 to 10 minutes. Now let's check on our Nutrella gravy. And it looks very good and it smells really delicious. And you can see how a simple ingredient can become a magical recipe with all these nice ingredients that I've added to this. And now our dish is complete. And I'm going to quickly make some tandoori rotis to go along with this sabji. I'm going to make two tandoori rotis to serve with our sabji. That's the Nutrella, Shahi Nutrella dish. And this is whole wheat flour. And I'm just going to rub in some dry flour and make two quick tandoori rotis. And I'm going to make it lachha style. It's like a lachha paratha. I'm just going to apply a little bit of oil to this, because I want to stick some black sesame seeds. This is the black sesame seeds that I'm just going to sprinkle on this. And just press it. And now I'm going to slowly lift this roti and apply some water on the back side. And just stick it on our tawa. Okay. Just stick it on your tawa. And I have a piece of charcoal here. And this will give a nice tandoori flavor to our tandoori roti. You can see how nice and bubbly it looks. Okay, now let's check on our roti. And our tandoori roti is ready. And I'm going to add a little bit of oil on this. And I've applied a little bit of olive oil on our tandoori roti, but you can also put some ghee on this. Okay, and our first tandoori roti is ready, and similarly I'm going to make another one. Now these are our tandoori rotis and our delicious Nutrella sabji, and it looks so delicious and I'm sure it's going to taste good as well. I hope you enjoyed this delicious recipe. Definitely try this at home and share your comments with me. And for more recipes, tune in till next time and don't forget to subscribe as well. Bye-bye.